Assalamu alaikum students, how are you all? Hope you are doing well and staying at home and follow all the instructions that are recommended by doctors to be protected from COVID-19. This is Sidra Hassan and today I am going to teach you number to 10,000, that is unit number 1, and our topic is expanding numbers. So our objective is, at the end of the lesson, students will be able to understand the concept of expanded form, write the expanded form of 4-digit numbers, and differentiate between the standard form and the expanded form of numbers. We have learned 4-digit numbers. This is a 4-digit number, 4789. Now we need to expand this number. What does the expansion mean? What does it mean? It means that we have to write the place value of these number and add them. So now if we have 4-digit number 4789, so we know that 4 is at the 1000 position, 7 is at the 100 position, 8 is at the 10th position, and 9 is at the 1's position. Now in expanding number, what we have to do, that we have to write the place value of each digit and then add them. Let's see how to do this. What will I do? 4 is at the 1000 position, so I will multiply it with 1000. 7 is at the 100 position, so I will multiply it with 100. 8 is at the 10th position, so I will multiply it with 10. And 9 is at the 1's position, so I will multiply it 1. Now I'm adding all of these digits, it become, and then multiply it, it become 4000 plus 700 plus 80 and plus 9. So this is actually expanded form. So I have written the place value of each digit and adding them to get the expanded form of the number. Now I am giving you another example. This is also a 4-digit number and the number is 2983. So now we can do directly. 2 is at the 1000 position, so it will be 2 multiplied by 1000, it will be 2000. 9 is at the 100 position, so 9 multiplied by 100 will be 900. 8 is at the 10th position, so 8 multiplied by 10 will be 80. 3 is at the 1's position, so 3 multiplied by 1 will be 3. So we can also write the expanded form like this. This is the expanded form of the number and this is how we can expand the 4-digit number. And if you add these number, then you can get the number 2983. Now we are moving from left to right. We can also write from right to left. If you write 3 plus 80 plus 900 plus 2000, it will be right also. So in expanded form, we are actually breaking the number into 1000, hundreds, tens, and ones. So for example, if the number is 8030, that's mean 8030, then what will I do? I will write the place value, then I will place the number. 8 is in the 1000 position, 0 is in the 100 position, 3 is at the 10th position, and 0 is at the 1's position. Right. Now, in expanded form, what will I do? I will write 8000 and 0 in place of 100, 3 tens, so it will be 30, 0 ones, so it will be 0. Now, I can also write 8000 plus 30. Mentioning 0 is not necessary, but both of these are correct. Now if the number is 5600, now what will we do? Again we write the place value of each digit. It will be 5000 plus 600 plus 0 plus 0. Okay, now I can skip 0. Okay, I can write 5000 plus 600. Okay, and this is not necessary to mention 0. But if you will write 5000 plus 600 plus 0 plus 0, it will also consider right. Okay. So now I have told you that how to convert the standard form of number into the expanded form. Now, if I am giving you expanded form of number, then how can you find out the extended form? Okay, if the addition signs are given and the place value is given, this is the actually expanded form, and the number is actually extended form. So here you can move. For example, if I'm giving you number 8000 plus 100 plus 90 plus 6, this is also simple and we can add it. I can write it, add it like 8000 plus 100 plus 90 plus 9, and I will get the answer 8199. It is the standard form. But this is slightly difficult to add all the numbers together. Now, even without adding, I can get the answer. How? As I have given you number 8000 plus 100 plus 90 plus 6. Now, what can you do? You can write the ones, tens, 100 and 1000. First, you will write the values, and then you will put the numbers below the value. For example, in the place of 1000, you will write 8000, so we will write 8. 100 will be placed at the place of 100, so it will be 1. 90 will be placed 90, 9 tens, so it will be 9, and 6 ones will be 6. You can see it again, 8000, as it is 8000, so I will put the number 8 below 1000. 100, so I will place 1 below 100, it indicates 100. 90 means 9 tens, so I will put 9 below tens, okay, and 6 below 1s. So if I so it is very simple that we can write it 8196. Okay, so if I have the number as 3000 plus 50 plus 8, now what will I do? Okay, first step will be I will write 1s, 10s, 100 and 1000. Okay, now I will place 3000 in the 1000 place, 50 in the tens position, okay, and 8 will be in the ones position. Now, have you seen that there is no 100? So what will I do? I will place 0, means it will be 3051, okay. I can repeat it again. It is 3000 plus 50 plus 8, there is no 100, okay, but I will not write 358. It will be wrong, right? What will I do? I will write 3058. In the same manner, if the number is giving 8000 plus 400 plus 6, here tens is not given. So I will write 8000 in the place of 1000, 400 in the place of 100, tens, in the place of tens, I will write 0. And in the place of ones, I will write 6. The number will be 8406. Okay, here again, it is written 2000 plus 9. Then what will I do? I will write ones, tens, 100,000 first. I will write the values first. Then I will put down the numbers. So 2000, as it is written 2000, so 2 will be placed below 1000. If I am placing the 2 below 1000, it indicates 2000. And 9 will be placed in the place of ones, and I can write directly 0 and 0 below 100 and tens, and the number will be 2009. I hope you understand the standard form of the number and the expanded form of the number. Okay, now you have to solve page number 6, 7 and 9 of your workbook 1. Thank you.